guys. Welcome to Learn French with Charlene. So this is basically our first meeting, and if you are here, it's either of two things. It's either you are very eager to learn the French language, or you just like to see pretty girls. Well, either way, I'm glad you're here. So like I said, my name is Anarado Charlene, and today I'm going to be teaching you how to do basic introduction like I just did, but in French. Because next time I would love to introduce my program in French, and I would love for you to understand when I do that. So if you want to introduce yourself in French with somebody who speaks French, there are a couple of ways you can do that. You know, you start out with the greetings and then the pleasantries and the exchange of names and, you know, a lot of those kind of things. So we're going to start with the greetings first. But let's remember one thing though. In French, they have different ways of addressing people depending on your relationship with the person, the age difference, or the reputation attached to the person. It basically means they have formal ways of speaking and informal ways of speaking. So when you meet somebody for the first time and they are not in your peer group, you probably just want to stick with the formal way. Anyways, we are going to, you know, learn both ways as we go on, so that you'll be in a position to judge when to be formal or when to be informal. So now when you meet somebody and you like want to introduce yourself in English, we normally say hello, hi, good morning, good afternoon, stuff like that. So in French, there is a particular very common word you can use for basically any kind of greeting. It's salut. Salut. So salut is like hello, hi, good morning, good afternoon, goodbye. So it's kind of a multi-purpose greeting word. So when you see somebody come like salut, 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 just like that. But take note, it's more of informal. You don't want to tell somebody who is higher in rank than you salut. It's going to maybe sound disrespectful. So in a more formal setting, you might probably just want to stick with bonjour. So bonjour is a way to greet people in a formal way. So let's remember that formal way can work in both formal and informal setting, but informal setting can only work in an informal setting. So you have bonjour. So bonjour literally means good day. So the word bon means good. It's an adjective that means bon. Then jour is the noun for day. So it's like good day. You can only use bonjour when there is still sunlight, because it's referring to the daytime. So you might just like want to use it during the daylight, so like in the morning or in the afternoon, or sometimes in the early evening, but you don't want it to exceed that, because once it's evening, there is a different greeting for that. You don't want to say bonjour anymore. So bonjour is good morning, good afternoon, and when it's evening, you want to say bonsoir. It's just like bonjour. Bon means good and soir means evening. So bonsoir is good evening. And at night, there is a greeting for that. Night is nuit. So when you want to say good night, it's bonne nuit. But notice that in this situation, there is a slight change in the spelling of bon. Let's note that French is very sensitive to gender and quantity. So when you are learning French, you want to keep it in your head that you need to take note of wherever there is a gender information for gender or for quantity, because they are definitely going to influence your choice of words. So like in the case of bonne nuit, because nuit is a feminine word, the bonne, which is the adjective, is going to take a feminine composition. And how to form feminine compositions is you add ne to bon, to make it bonne. So now for night, you say bonne nuit. I'm sorry, this is going to get easier as we go on, the whole gender and quantity thing, but we're going to take it one step at a time. So anyone we meet, we just, you know, like run it over like that. But just keep it in your mind that every single noun in French is either male or female, right? So along the line, we're going to also learn how to address them in both definite and indefinite situations. So now we have learned three very important ways of greeting in the formal way. Bonjour, which is good morning, good afternoon, good day. Bonsoir, which is good evening. And bonne nuit, which is good night. And we've also learned how to use salut. Salut can be used for basically any kind of greeting in the informal setting. Don't forget that informal setting, that's when you can use salut. Now, when you want to, you know, go further in the introduction, I mean, when you tell people bonjour, bonsoir, salut, you don't want to stop there. You want to go ahead and talk about a lot of other things like your name, how they are doing and stuff like that. So you want to say your name in French. You already know that. Je m'appelle. When you say je m'appelle, you add your name to it. So I want to say, for example, my name is Charline. In French, I'll just say, je m'appelle Charline. Je m'appelle Charline. It's that simple. You are going to try it, but then you are going to use your name because I know your name is not Charline. So when you say, je m'appelle, you add your name. Can you try to say it? Je m'appelle Charline. Je m'appelle Charline, then that is for me. So when you want to say you are name, your name is, you say tu t'appelles your name. So let me assume your name now is Gabriel. Je m'appelle Charline, tu t'appelles Gabriel. Je m'appelle Charline, tu t'appelles Gabriel. So just like in English, in French we have pronouns too. So the pronouns are je, tu, il, elle, nous, vous, il, elle. So what I basically just said is I, you, he, she, we, you, they. Now we have two days in French because, like I already told you, in French they have gender and quantity. So when you say they in French, they have a different day for when you're talking to, when you're talking about all male they, like the whole of the day they are men and the whole of the day they are female. So you have il and elle for that. So we have je for I, tu for you. This tu for you is an informal you and for singular. So you want to say tu to somebody who's within your age range and who is just one person. Nous for we. Vous for you. Now, vous is basically like the plural of tu. So while tu is one person, vous is a group of people. So it's like you people, you guys, vous. But it can also be used to address one person if this one person is somebody who is way much older than you, or like someone who's higher in rank. So it's more like a formal kind of vous. It's somebody you want to accord respect to. So you don't want to say tu, you say vous for this person. Now we have il. Il, that's they. But this day is basically when you're talking about a group of guys. So they are all men. So they for il for they, and then elle for they. Just like it is for the when they are all guys, elle is when they are all female. But then when there is a group of female with guys, so when it's a mixture of guys and girls, you use the ill form of the day. Even if it's just one guy in the midst of a lot of women, you still want to use the ill form. The one who used to address the male, you use it. So once there is a male in the group, the day becomes ill. Okay, so now, if you want to say, my name is, your name is, his name is, her name is, your names are, our names are, their names are, their names are. I suppose you know how to do that now. Je m'appelle Charlene. Tu t'appelles Gabriel. Il s'appelle. Whatever his name is. Elle s'appelle. Whatever her name is. Nous nous appelons. We now say our names. Vous vous appelez. Il s'appelle. Elle s'appelle. I'm sure you probably noticed during the construction of the sentences that the verbs change their form according to the pronoun they are attached to. That is what we call conjugation. But this is not a class for today. We are going to do that in our subsequent classes, how to conjugate verbs. So just like in English too, when you conjugate verbs, the pronoun decides the form the verb is going to take. So when you say, I am, you are. So you see, you don't say, I am, you am, he am, she am. No, you say, I am, you are, he is, she is. It's the same way in French. So the pronouns, they determine the form the verbs are going to take. So you want to pay attention to conjugation when you are learning French. So I hope you already learned how to greet, how to say your name. Now, how about if you want to ask somebody, how are you doing? You know, you already passed the pleasantries. Now you want to know how they are doing. You ask them, comment ça va? Comment ça va? Comment ça va means, how is it going? That is the literal translation, like word for word. How is it going? Comment ça va? But then generally just means, how are you? How far? What's up? So when you tell somebody comment ça va, you are expecting the person to tell you how they are doing, whether they're good or they're not, or they're just there. So that's the kind of response you be expecting. So now when somebody says comment ça va, there are a lot of ways to actually ask this question. So we'll come to them one after the other. So the first one is comment ça va. Comment ça va is, how are you doing? You can also say, comment allez-vous? Comment allez-vous? Comment allez-vous? Comment allez-vous is, how are you doing? But it's more like a formal, you're attaching a kind of formality to it. So it's expected that whoever you're talking to is of a higher level than you. So, comment allez-vous? Comment vas-tu? Comment vas-tu is also informal. Basically, whenever you see tu, you just know it's informal, right? And whenever you see vous, it's formal. That if it's not plural, then it's definitely formal, right? So, comment vas-tu? Comment ça va? Comment allez-vous? They all mean, how are you doing? Now, if somebody asks you how you are doing, there are a million ways to respond to that question. So we're just going to look at a couple that we use most often. So you can say très bien, très bien, very good. Yeah, I'm very good. Très bien. You can say pas mal, pas mal, not bad. So pas mal means not bad, you know, not very good, but not bad. You can also say, je vais mal, je vais mal. I'm doing badly, I'm not good, you know. It's pretty bad, je vais mal. You can say, pas très bien, pas très bien. So if très bien means very well, pas très bien means not very well. So I'm not doing well at all, so. You can say, comme ci, comme ça. Comme ci, comme ça is like literally it means like this, like that. So when somebody says they are like this, like that, yeah, you probably guess right. It basically means they're just there, you know, just so-so, you know, they're just there. So these and many more, a couple of ways you can respond to comment tu vas, je vais bien, pas mal, comme ci, comme ça, pas très bien, je vais mal. So these are the ways you can ask people how they are doing and how you can respond to how you are doing. So let's do a quick recap of what we've learned today, because I want to believe you learned as much as I taught. So we started with how to greet. So let's like run a quick dialogue now, right? Okay. Bonjour, bonjour, salut, salut, bonsoir, bonne nuit. These are all ways to say hello. Je m'appelle Charline. Je m'appelle Charline. Tu t'appelles comment? My name is Charline. What is your name? Je m'appelle Charline. Tu t'appelles comment? My name is Charline. What is your name? Right? Comment tu vas? Comment allez-vous? Comment ça va? They all mean, how are you doing? Je vais bien. Très bien, merci. Very well, thank you. Je vais mal. Pas très bien. Comme si, comme ça. These are all ways to respond. Now, you probably don't want to continue the conversation anymore and you want to go. There are also a couple of ways to say goodbye, or you probably hope you're going to see them again. There's also a couple of ways to say something that is going to suggest that you meet again. So after the whole introduction and pleasantries, saying your name, you say enchanté. Enchanté. You can just say enchanté. Enchanté means pleased to meet you. I'm enchanted to meet you. That's literally, but it means pleased to meet you. You can say enchanté de faire votre connaissance. Enchanté de faire votre connaissance. That's, I am pleased to meet you. Enchanté de faire votre connaissance. You can still add je suis enchanté. I am pleased. You can also stretch the sentence to go a bit longer. You say, je suis enchanté de faire votre connaissance. I am pleased to meet you. And we know that since there is votre, it means this is a formal way of saying pleased to meet you. If you want to say it in the informal form, you can either still say enchanté. You can also say enchanté de faire ta connaissance. Enchanté de faire ta connaissance. Pleased to meet you. Je suis enchanté de faire ta connaissance. I am pleased to meet you, pleased to have met you. Now you want to go and you want to say goodbye. The very informal way to say it is salut. Like you learned in the beginning, salut can mean hello, it can also mean goodbye. So you can say salut, salut. I'm on my way. But then if you want to be a bit formal, you can say au revoir, au revoir. So au revoir, that's for a more formal setting. You say au revoir, au revoir. Then you can say à bientôt, à bientôt. À bientôt means see you soon. Bientôt means literally, bien means good, tôt means early. So it's like at good early. It doesn't make any sense though, but it means see you soon. So bientôt, soon. I'm hoping to see you soon. A bientôt. À tout à l'heure. À tout à l'heure. À tout à l'heure means if you break it down word for word, it's probably going to come out meaningless, but as a word, à tout à l'heure means see you soon, you know, like very soon. But if you can say, You can say, ah, demain, à demain. Demain means tomorrow. So, à demain means till tomorrow. So, that basically means you are going to see the person tomorrow. So, à demain. So, just like you can see the person tomorrow, you can also see the person next week, next month, next year, next whatever. So, whatever you want to say, next Monday, next Tuesday. So, whether it's tomorrow or the day after tomorrow or weekend or whenever you want to see the person, once you add à before that particular type of construction, it becomes till then. So, à demain means till tomorrow. À lundi, we're going to treat the days of the week later. For now, lundi means Monday. So, à lundi means till Monday. À lundi. À mardi, till Tuesday. See you Tuesday. So, that's basically how to say all these things. So, I hope you enjoyed the lesson. And if you did, I'm going to, let's play a little game. You are going to, how do I do it? Okay, fine. I ask you simple questions based on what we learned today, and you're going to leave your answers in the comment box. Don't check your Google, you know, so you want to make sure you actually follow the class. So don't check Google, just trust in yourself, all right? Answers in the comments section, and thank you for tuning in to Learn French with Charlene. I hope to see you next episode. If you know anybody who is interested in learning French or who wants to go to a French country, you can direct them to my channel. I promise we're going to be doing a lot of fun things. I'm going to make sure you learn this French the easiest way that you can. I mean, I did it, I learned it, so if I did it, why can't you, right? So subscribe, stay tuned on Learn French Challenge. Bye.